All right, Oren, stand by for a second. Back here with Peter Beiner. Peter, that organization that he's talking about is called Miftah, which is an organization that in the past has published articles on their website using phrases like blood libel, which in the past on their website has praised Palestinians who've carried out attacks against Israelis. And this was the organization that was involved with the planning of that trip. Now, you heard Ilhan Omar refer to that obliquely in her statement, but is that a type of organization that you should be connected with as a U.S. member of Congress?
Palestinians don't have to be saints in order to deserve rights that all of us take for granted, right? Miftah has said things that I disagree with. They made an anti-Semitic statement that they apologized for. The point is, when you go there, I say this as an American Jew. My children go to Jewish day school. I lead services in an Orthodox synagogue. Judaism is at the center of my life. The first time I went to spend time with Palestinians in the West Bank, it was a shattering experience. The only thing I could imagine would be similar for American would be going to visit the Jim Crow South. When you see people living under the control of the state with no rights, they cannot become citizens. They cannot vote for the control for the state that controls their lives. They do not have free movement. They need a pass to move from city to city. They live under a military legal system. The consequences are more brutal than we can imagine sitting here. So do I agree with Miftah? Of course not. I had a close friend who was killed in a suicide bombing. But Palestinians don't. You could have made the same argument if you went to visit SNCC and said, oh, they were connected with communists. Some of their people have made anti-white statements. The point is, what Ilhan Omar said is the most important point. People need to go and see for themselves. I've never seen anyone who's gone and seen for themselves and not been transformed by the experience.
That, I think, is true and apolitical, that it is worth going to Israel, worth going to the West Bank so you can see for yourself. You get a real sense of the situation on the ground. Rich Lowry, on the subject of Miftah, the other side of that is that there has been a congressional trip that was led by Miftah before, and the Israeli government let it happen. Now, I know it was before the actual law was passed, but they didn't need a law to keep people out if they didn't want to, but they allowed it to happen before. Now they're not, and claiming it's because of this organization.
Yeah, well, obviously the proximate cause here was the Trump tweet, which highlighted this and made it a major issue. But there is a law that allows Israel to ban foreigners who support the BDS movement to isolate and delegitimize Israel. It's been not applied against members of Congress before. It's been applied against French politicians, against EU politicians, but these are strong supporters of the BDS movement. They're not honest brokers. We wouldn't afford a white nationalist organization the leeway that Peter is giving this organization. Oh, they're not saints. This is an anti-Semitic group that supported terrorism, supports blowing up innocent civilians and children. And no matter what you think of the dispute between the Palestinians and Israel, that is an illegitimate tactic that no one should associate with advocates of.
Want a quick response to that, Peter? Then I want to bring
Sure. Hanan Shrog is actually very well known as a nonviolent activist, been a critic of the Palestinian Authority, one of the most important Palestinian feminists. There are many Palestinians who believe that Palestinians have the right to use violence because of the daily violent oppression they feel. I disagree with them. I believe in only nonviolent protest. But the point is, every time any Palestinian leader or any Palestinian organization tries to expose what happens, this is exactly what happens. People try to discredit them because they don't want to talk about the real issue. The real issue is an absolutely indefensible denial of basic human rights.
What's that have to do with supporting terrorism? I mean, no one has any problem with harshly criticizing Israel. That's fine. But you don't support blowing up innocent people. That's just a bottom line.
No, of course not. The purpose behind focusing on this is to try to distract attention from the reality on the ground, which is funded by American tax dollars. Our tax dollars blow up the homes of people who cannot get permits to build because they're non-citizens under military law.
Would this be your standard for a white nationalist organization?
They support some terrorism. With all due respect,
but that's okay.
You have
You're
not been there and
me.
Seen this on the ground. Hanan Ashrawi. She is nothing close to a white nationalist. She is someone seeking freedom.
But then why does the organization publish things supporting terrorism?
Rich, I disagree with violent resistance.
No, but why
but
do they?
It is because a lot of Palestinians believe that because they are subject to daily violence of a system which denies them basic rights, they have the right to respond violently. I disagree with them. But an African American who supported violence against the United States under slavery or Jim Crow, that did not excuse their denial of basic rights because I disagree with the tactic they were using to resist it.
I mean, it's fine to harshly criticize Israel and the occupation, But I don't think anyone's be associated with a group that supports terrorism. And this isn't black or white. I mean, they publish this stuff. No one's forcing them to publish this stuff.
There were certain statements on their website. Hannah Nasrallah, he's devoted her life as a nonviolent activist to opposing an oppression which none of us does not accord with the values that any of us believe in as Americans.
So she doesn't control her own organization and what it publishes?
Rich, why don't you try spending a little bit of time focusing on the fact that almost $4 billion of U.S. aid is used to put children
in
detention.
You're the one distracting from the issue.
National Review defended apartheid, and just as you defended segregation, you now defend Israel's oppression of Palestinian basic rights. It's a tradition for you guys.
Look, and if an organization supports terrorism, that organization should be beyond the pale.
And when Palestinians protest nonviolently, you discredit them as well.
So you're saying that, in some sense, justifies terrorism?
Of course it doesn't justify terrorism. I've said again and again I disagree with terrorism. What I'm saying is you're trying to distract from the real issue. The real issue is American complicity in the denial of basic Palestinians.
All right, we're going to leave this, guys.
What's the content of your opposition mean
if you
won't condemn this organization?
Rich, please go there yourself.
We're going to leave that there. Rich, Peter, guys, stand by. Much more ahead, including a look at President's